Hello, I'm Riata Scott and I'm back with part 3 of creating a newsletter from scratch with InDesign CS6. In this video, we'll style our master page. So I'm going to open pages here and you'll see you have your master page at the top or pages, and then here are the pages of our document. And you'll notice that there is a letter A on each page. That just means that they are based on the A master. Every new document that you create has a master page whether you end up using it or not. So what this one has, the A master, and that's what we're on right now, is the margins and columns that we set up when we originally created this document. So anything we put on the master page here will show up on these actual pages here as long as they are based on the A master, which these are. Now the first thing I'm going to do is add a background. So we'll go File, Place, and I'll find my background image. And I'm just going to drop it right there. So you'll notice that now pages 1 and 2 also have that background. And that's fine because I want them both to have that background. I'm going to add the logo and a few other elements off camera so that we can speed this along a little bit, and then we'll go to some of the next steps. Okay, so I've added a few more items to the A master, and as you can see, those elements are now part of pages 1 and 2. And if you go to those pages, you'll notice that each of these items has a little lock on it, and you're not able to select them. You can actually Control-Shift-Click and select them and get rid of them if you want to, but that would defeat the purpose of having a master. So let's go back up to master. Oh, and I want to show you one thing. If you hit W on your keyboard, you'll get a preview of what it looks like. So you can see that this oval is chopped off. It's just part of this element. And I'll hit W again to bring all of that back. Now, what we're going to do is create a second master, and it'll be called B master until we change the name. And we'll apply that to the second page, because on the second page, I want a little more white space to add more content. So we'll move some things around. So we'll do that by, we're going to be on the Pages panel, and we're going to access the Pages panel menu and click New Master. And the prefix B is fine. We can leave the name Master, but I'm just going to change that to Back. And we are going to base that on the other master. If we put None here, then we would end up with a blank page on the second one. But we want some of the same elements that are in the A master. So we'll click here and choose A master. And only one page, so we'll go ahead and say OK. So now we have a B master, and we are actually on that right now. And again, just like on the pages, all of the elements are locked. But this time we do need to unlock them so that we can make some changes. First things first, I'm going to get rid of a few things. So to unlock them, I hold down Control and Shift while I click. So I'm not going to need this bird. So I've unlocked it now. You can see the bounding box, and I'll just hit delete on my keyboard, make that go away. And then Control Shift, I'm going to try to get just this transparent oval. Hopefully that is what I got. So I'm going to hit delete. Yes, and that is gone. Everything else I want to keep on this page, I just want to move some things. So once again, to save time, I've done a little bit of the editing off camera. I changed the size of the oval, added this little parrot and this little monkey. And I left a couple of things for last just so I could show you how to do them. So News for Kids, that logo is behind the oval. Obviously, we're going to need to move that and resize it. So we'll Control-Shift-Click to grab hold of it. And then I'm going to right-click, choose Arrange, and bring to front, and that brings it to the front. Now to change size, if I simply grab the corner bounding box and click and drag down, change it to the size I want, it just changes the size of the box, not the image itself, so we're just missing some of the image. So let me Control Z. So to actually change the size and the box, we're going to hold down Control Shift as we click and drag, and we'll make it smaller. And then I'll just use my arrow keys to nudge that into place. I need it a little bit smaller. And I was holding Control Shift again, obviously. And that looks pretty good. Of course, Mizzou also is the wrong size, so I'll Control Shift click that. And then Control Shift and drag to make that a little bit smaller as well. Now that our B master is ready, our second page master, we're ready to apply it to the second page. And you'll notice that there's an A on it, and that's just because it is based on the A master. So I don't want you to get confused by that. But to apply it to the second page, simply click and drag the B master thumbnail. Drag it down here until you see the dark outline on page 2 and let go. And now you see the B on the thumbnail. If you double click to go to page 2, you'll see that it has all of those elements on our B master and that they are all locked. So that's it for master pages, and in the next video we'll go ahead and start actually adding content to our pages. Before I end this video, I'd like to mention that IT Training offers free beginning and advanced courses in InDesign as well as other software for all students and staff. So if you're interested in learning more, log into training.missouri.edu today and register for a class.